All right, this is Dr. Watt, and we're here with Deanna. Deanna is almost 75, looking great, and she is from here in South Jordan. And we'd like to thank her for doing this testimonial for us. Deanna, what symptoms brought you into the office originally?
I had been taking thyroid medication for several years and was getting a little tired of taking a pill every morning for thyroid and not really seeing any great results. It just stayed the same. And so I didn't know where to go or what to even do to correct that. My doctor just kept giving me the thyroid pills.
What were some of the kind of the major symptoms that you had going on?
Probably some mood swings, the loss, well, my hair, losing some hair, mm-hmm. Every time I brushed, and the energy level was my forced energy because I knew I had to do certain things. Mm-hmm. And I knew there was something different that...
Just kind of overall just didn't feel like you thought you should. Okay.
Just didn't. I knew I could feel better. I was waking up in the middle of the night, not getting able to go back to sleep for a couple hours. Oh. And that I didn't like because then I was tired in the morning.
Right, right. How did you hear about our office?
Well, I was at... Can I say curves?
Uh-huh. Yeah, you can say curves.
I was exercising. I decided because I was gaining weight that I really wanted to get on an exercise program. Mm-hmm. So I was talking with the coach at Curves, and she told me about Dr. Watt.
Oh, okay.
And she said, I know he holds workshops. And I said, oh, great. And so that's when I called to find out a workshop because I was ready to do anything.
Well, good. We're glad you came in. When you came into the office for that workshop, what impressed you about what you heard that made you want to go a little further and do the actual evaluation?
Well, I realized there were other people that were just like I was. And I enjoyed your video, the presentation that you gave telling me really how the thyroid works and what I need to improve and what kind of tests need to be done to know exactly what to do with you, the thyroid. Mm-hmm. And Dr. Watt was very nice and he answered questions thoroughly.
You mean I didn't put my hands around your throat saying, you need to come in, you need to come in, nothing like that?
He was very nice.
Well, good.
And the book was very informative also, which I was instructed to read the first 90 pages.
That's right.
And I did.
Well, good. What interested you most about doing the actual thyroid program? So after you came in for the workshop, then you decided to come in for the evaluation. We did the neurological evaluation. Had you ever had anything done like that before?
Never, never. And that was interesting because... I didn't know I had so much.
Didn't realize there was some neurological components to the thyroid thing, right?
When you talk about your brain,
right?
You kind of wonder really how you've gotten along mm-hmm. all these years.
So what interested you most, I guess, in deciding to actually go ahead and do the program?
Well, I really was confident that you could really help me. And through the testing, I found out a lot of things about me and my body that I had no idea.
Such as, kind of give me a couple examples.
Such as, well, the one thing we found out I was gluten intolerant, okay. which was a lot of my digestive problem that I had.
Right. And you've been living with that for years and had no clue,
years.
Right?
And I love those kind of things that I found out were making me sick. Mm-hmm. So... I realized that there were a lot of things and that through the therapy, it could help.
And then were you also, did we, I don't have your paperwork in front of me, so we're just doing this. Were you Hashimoto's as well?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, that was the one thing that you determined through the
blood test as well. And that makes it a totally different ball game as well.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And also, I can say that I found that there, when somebody asked me what I was doing, and I said, well, they've determined that I've got Hashimoto's. And they said, oh, I've heard of that. And I have a thyroid problem too, so.
Yeah, unfortunately, there's a lot of people that have it. What were some of the, well, you kind of already mentioned a little bit, what were some of the changes that you had to make in your own life with the program that we did?
Probably a few things that I was eating. I had more energy to exercise, which I've always been an active person.
Mm-hmm.
But as you get older, you kind of slow down a little bit, and I was trying not to. And the foods that I was eating was probably the biggest change.
Okay. How soon did you start feeling symptoms decrease or go away?
Probably a couple of months.
Maybe. Okay. So it took a little bit of time before you started seeing it.
Because your body, I know, has to adjust to certain things.
Mm-hmm. But that's really good for people to understand, because a lot of times people want, you know, they're so used to taking a pill that makes an instantaneous change, but it doesn't fix anything. But, you know, if it takes a little bit of time before your body starts changing. And also, the first month or so, we're doing the testing and all those kinds of things. But like with energy level and stuff like that, because that usually comes on a little bit quicker than the thyroid symptoms.
I was still going to curves, exercising, and also using the treadmill at home, because I was really trying to make this go a little faster than what it wanted to, particularly.
Sorry, we had a little bit of technical difficulties there. She was talking about how soon she felt the changes.
Yeah, it was probably the first month, second month, that I could really see that
something was changing.
I'm really good.
Right.
And the thing I like so much is the supplements that you take are not druggy.
Mm-hmm.
And I hate pills as it is, but knowing that these were going to help me, I could take them.
Great. After completing the thyroid program, what has been the biggest positive factor in your life, I guess?
Well, it's not only helped me, but it's helped my husband too. Because now I've got him on a regimen, kind of, that he has to eat whatever I fix.
So he's eating healthier and doing better.
He's eating healthier. When I go exercise, he's on the treadmill.
Oh, good.
So it works out both ways. We travel, and that's kind of the big boost. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm ready to go all the time.
And I'm just going to add a little bit to this right here is Deanna was celebrating her 50-year anniversary last year. And
this year.
But it's been a whole year. They've been doing all these things. So she has literally probably been in 10 different states at least, several different countries, all over the place, traveling a week here, a week there. They're really doing up their 50-year anniversary, which is awesome for them. But the nice thing is, everything was great except for when you were in China and got sick.
I got sick. Don't eat the lettuce.
But overall, I mean, would you have been able to do that prior to, do you think you would have enjoyed it as much? I mean, you probably still would have done it just because it was your 50-year anniversary. But you probably, you know, I don't want to put words in your mouth, but is that fair to say that you enjoyed it a whole lot more because of feeling better?
I would say I did. And because I knew I had the energy to go.
Mm-hmm.
Tours are really strenuous. We were flying from different city to different city, and it was, when we got there, it was tours, and it was go, go, go.
Right.
And you're tired at night, but it was a good tired. And
because you've been to China, but you've been to multiple different other places as well. Yeah. So she's traveled the world and been able to do it and enjoy that. In fact, that's one of the things that people put on there when their questionnaire, what do you want to do? You know, one of those is travel, and you've been able to do that, so that's great. Why would you recommend the program that we do in this office to other people?
It's not a hard program.
Now, it's, don't lie, because it's not easy either.
It's not easy, mm-hmm. because you do have to
make changes.
Yeah. Yourself to doing the good things that are going to help you. And but I have to say that Dr. Watts, he's very knowledgeable about what he does, and that interests me, because some people, I won't say anything.
No negatives.
No negatives. No, but
we're not just giving pills like most people do, but we're not.
Several different people are in this office, and everybody has a different kind of problem. But it's all related to the Hashimoto's and the thyroid problem.
Yeah, the thyroid.
Some are more affected than others. And he takes a very personal interest in helping you.
Huh. All right. Well, thank you very much. Is there anything else you want to say before we close?
I would say that if you think you've got a thyroid problem and the doctor keeps giving you pills to get over it, or if your energy level is down, or you're losing hair, you're gaining weight, those kind of things, you need to get in your mind that you need to do some kind of regimen to take care of it.
All right. Thank you so much. We appreciate it. Thanks, Deanna. Mm-hmm.